It's a pleasure to be with you one more time. I'm going to ask you to look with me this morning to Mark 10, reading verses 28 to 30. Father, I give you thanks one more time for this privilege that you has given unto us, that we can gather together, sit around your table, and enjoy your presence as we share worship together. Your word said, behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. We may not see each other physically, but we are connected in spirit. We are connected through your shed blood. And we just want to thank you for this opportunity that we can worship you in this manner this day. Bless us as you minister to us from your word. May we be encouraged to trust you in Jesus' name. Amen. Mark 10, 28 to 30. And I'm going to talk a little on giving up all for Jesus. Giving up all for Jesus. Then Peter began to say unto him, speaking of Jesus, lo, we have left all and followed thee. And Jesus answered and said, verily, I say unto you, there is no man that has left house or brethren or sisters or father or mother or wife or children or land for my sake and the gospel's, but he shall receive an hundredfold now in this time, houses, brothers, sisters, mothers, children, and land with persecution, and in the world to come, eternal life. Praise the name of the Lord. Many of us have made sacrifices in this life, because we have set goals for ourselves. And in order for us to be successful, we have to put everything into building up ourselves so we can reach these goals and to be successful. If we set a goal and we don't make any move or make any plans to reach that goal, we would remain the same place. And the time that we set to complete that goal, we will find out that we were unsuccessful. Now, Jesus, talking to the young ruler that came to him, he said, you have to give up all. This young ruler, he was rich. And he wanted to know from Jesus, what must I do to be saved? He came to Jesus and he asked him that question. Master, what shall I do to be saved? Jesus said to him, you know the commandments. Do not commit adultery. Do not kill. Do not steal. Don't bear false witness. Honor your parents. And the young ruler replied, all these I have kept from my youth. Now, looking at it, you could say that he was very self-righteous. He did everything right. So in his own eyes, he figured, I am good. I am cool. I am ready. I should be saved. I should be able to inherit eternal life. But Jesus said unto him, all these things you have kept from your youth, you didn't miss anything out, but you lack one thing. Yeah, he was missing something, and he was missing the most important thing. Jesus said, you lack one thing. Sell everything you have and give to the poor, and you would have treasures in heaven. The young man became very sad and went away grief. The young man had riches. He kept all the commandments, but he lacked one thing. Or we can say he lacked a couple of things, because he lacked sympathy. He lacked empathy. He lacked compassion. He lacked bowels of mercy. So he was disappointed when Jesus said to him, sell everything and give it away, and not give it to any and everybody, because you can't give it to your rich friends. You can't give it to your rich families. I want you to give it to the less fortunate. Give it away to the poor. Now, in order for us to follow Jesus, there are some things we have to give up. The writer said, come as I am without one plea, but that his blood was shed for me. And as he bids me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come. We have to come to Jesus empty and broken. We have to come to him giving up all, giving up everything. We cannot hold back anything from him. What is God asking you and I to give up this morning to follow him? I joined with one songwriter and said, my all is on the altar of sacrifice laid. My heart and spirit, I ask him to control. I want to give him everything. I want to give him all of me. What is he asking us to give up? Is it our families? Is it our jobs? Is it our possession? The thing that we love most? Is that what he's asking us to sacrifice this morning? Let's think about it and free ourselves of these things that we can follow him wholeheartedly and that we can give him our all. Peter, the bold disciple of Jesus, said, lo, we have left all and followed thee. Some of Jesus' disciples were fishermen, tax collectors, doctors. They had different professions. These were tradesmen. They had families. They had jobs. And they give up their trades and their families to follow Jesus and the gospel. And when Peter said to Jesus, we have given up everything, we sacrificed everything to follow you, Jesus says to him, everything you give up in this life would be restored 100 times, and in the end, you will receive eternal life. Jesus said, and we'll find that in verse 29, Jesus answered and said, verily I said unto you, there is no man that has left house, his brothers, his sisters, his father, his mother, his wife, and children that has given up his land for my sake and the gospel, that would not receive 100-fold what he has given up. And he said you would receive it with persecution. And in this world, that's what we're going to receive. But you have something better coming in the world to come. And the life after death, you will receive eternal life. What has God called us to give up this morning? To follow Jesus, we have to give up everything. To inherit eternal life, it calls for a sacrifice. The most important things to us that aren't acceptable to God, we have to give them up. If you have money, you have to give it up. If you have fortune, you have to give it up. If you have wealth, you have to give it up. For the scripture tells us, wheresoever a man's heart is, wheresoever a man's treasure is, there will his heart be also. So if our heart is set on the things that we have in this life, we cannot serve God wholeheartedly. Luke 14:33 said, so likewise, whosoever he be of you that forsaketh not all that he has cannot be my disciples. So to be a disciple of Jesus Christ, we have to give up everything. In other words, you have to count the cost. Jesus teaches, if you desire to follow him and be his disciples, you should first decide whether or not you are prepared to pay the cost. The cost of real discipleship is to give up all relationships and possessions. Does this mean you must give away all the things that you have that you need to live on? No. It calls for us to share whatever we have, because Jesus, after he left and his disciples went out after the day of Pentecost, preaching the gospel, the word said they had all things common, and those that had, they sell what they have, they brought it, and they brought the stuff, and they placed them at the disciples' feet. And there was distributed among the brethren, and they had all things in common. The cost of real discipleship is to give up all other relationships and possessions. Jesus must be the first place in our lives. It is not that we're going to reject anybody. It is not that we're going to reject what we have. It simply just means that we must put Jesus first. Anything that we put before God, anything that we place in our lives before Jesus, anything that is more important in our lives than Christ Jesus is an idol. 1 John 2:15 said, do not love the world or anything in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in them. Jesus prayed to his Father, Father, keep them in the world, but keep them out, take them not out of the world, but keep them from the things of the world. Yes, Jesus prayed for us already. When he prayed for his disciples, he prayed for everyone that would follow after his disciples. And he asked his Father not to take the disciples out of the world, but to keep them from the things of the world. And we are still serving a prayer answering God and a prayer-keeping God, and he would keep whatsoever we commit to him. If we commit our lives to him wholeheartedly, if we sacrifice our all for him, if we give up our all and give him our best, he is able to keep it. Believers in Christ, we are strangers and we are pilgrims in this world. We are seeking a city to come. We are seeking a building not made with hands. We are looking forward for our Redeemer and our soon coming King. What are you going to give up today? Are you going to give up all? Are you going to give Jesus Christ all of you? Are you going to deny yourself? For Christ said, if we must follow him, we have to deny ourselves and come after him. I encourage us this morning to let's forget about the things of the world, the material things that will sidetrack us, and let us set our affections on things above, looking unto Jesus Christ, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. To give our all is to give ourselves totally to him. It is to deny ourselves of everything and follow him wholeheartedly. May we this morning see ourselves as Jesus sees us and trust him as we give him our all, as we sacrifice everything and follow him. In the end, we will inherit eternal life. In this life, he would give us more than our hearts desire. And in the time to come, after this life, we shall inherit eternal life. Father, I thank you this morning for the word. I thank you because you are a promise-keeping God. You said those that will follow you must deny themselves. We come this morning denying ourselves, giving of ourselves to you. We ask that you would take all of us, take everything from us, empty us out of everything, oh God, that would come as a separating, or that would separate us from you, oh Father, this morning, and bridge the gap that we could serve you freely and wholeheartedly, giving her all to you in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.